So when we set out to shoot two films in 2 weeks in two very different destinations, thousands of miles apart, we always knew it was going to be a challenge. We were following two photographers and they were going to be using the Nikon Z7, and we'd been tasked with shooting the film on that same camera. So this is a look behind the scenes.
Yeah, I hope for the best. Mother Nature is in charge.
Out of the doors, right over the mountaintops.
Let's go.
So we always knew that the hiking scenes in Norway were going to be tricky due to the fact that we only had 6 hours of light per day. That meant we needed to hike up, shoot the scene, and get back down before it got dark. Combine this with the icy conditions and the fact that we were all carrying up equipment, we knew we needed to move quick.
It's a lot trickier than we first thought. Every little corner we get to that we think maybe this is the view, it's just another whole steep peak.
We're going to lose the light very quickly, man.
For this part of the shoot, we were just using a small handheld setup, and it allowed us literally to keep the camera clipped to the front of our bag the whole time. This meant that even as we climbed up the final part of the hike, we had the camera accessible, and that meant we could capture the entire journey.
Oh, we're trying to get the drone shot. You can see the sun is going down over that side for 5-10 minutes.
So to get the aerial shots using the Z7, we'll be using the Alta 8 drone.
All right, you can go in if you want.
And throughout the 4 days in Norway, having the 24-70 Z mount lens on the camera on that drone meant that we could get an incredible range of shots. We were able to get some much closer perspectives along with the wider frames that you're used to seeing from a drone shot. At the same time, because we were shooting in 4K and outputting to 1080p, we had the luxury of cropping into the frame if we needed to. With the helicopter scene, the key was to work out exactly what angles we wanted to shoot from before the heli took off.
Should we put the S on? We're going to get people harnessed into the side and then we're going to take back off with the doors open. Out of the doors, it's going to be coming right over the mountaintops to reveal the beach.
I just don't completely trust the gimbal to hold the extra kilos of the weight from the propellers. So we're trying to figure out if it's possible to do it handheld or not.
That's perfect.
It comes with. Like, that's like, I'm dead.
So once I'd convinced Johan that he wasn't going to fall out the side, we got up into the air. And we did actually end up shooting the majority of the heli scene handheld. Having the camera held out the side of the helicopter was difficult, and the inbuilt stabilization inside the Z7 really did help here. We ended up getting some really cool perspectives of the photographers hanging out the side door of the heli. So the big wide open spaces of Norway were just a complete contrast to the busy, bustling streets of Singapore.
So we're just here in the busy streets of Chinatown, Singapore. It's amazing down here. So yeah, we're getting the shots, we're gonna run before the rain hits.
So with limited space and very busy streets, we'll be using the stabilizer a lot here to get more cinematic shots. And we combine this with the 50 frames per second on the Z7 to get some movement into the shots from some really unique angles.
And action.
Just a random thing. Yeah, it's good to have a subject sometimes. Usually my friends get me to jump, and that's why I have a hashtag #JumpsGerald. All the pictures across the years of my friends capturing me jumping in at different facades. And now there are like different people, random people, just using the hashtags.
Go! Okay, so we're at the hawker market, food market. We want to get some shots of the people cooking.
having a small handheld rig like this, the Nikon Z7. At the moment we've got the 35mm Z mount lens 1.8 connected to the Atomos Ninja 5 that enables us to shoot 10-bit ProRes video. When we're in these kind of places, although we want to get the cinematic shots, we also want to get the reactions.
At the popular tourist spots in Singapore, the biggest challenge was just the sheer number of people.
Thank you very much.
So at times when it was very busy and very hectic, being able to very quickly set up the Z7 on a tripod and use the inbuilt time-lapse mode was very useful.
So we've got a time-lapse set up, we've got the stabilizer, a handheld, we've got these two taking photos, and the laser show across the bay is going to last for about 5 minutes, so no pressure.
So as the shoot wound down and came to an end, we look back on what have been an incredible 2 weeks. It's very rare that you get to shoot in so many different scenarios in such a short space of time. And the Z7 really did live up to the task.
Well done, boys.
Some great memories, some great experiences. This was certainly a project that none of us were going to forget.